Hi everybody. In today's video, we will be discussing the multiple choice questions of pharmaceutics, one question paper of CSVTU 2020-21 exam. It is the subject of B.Pharm first semester PCI syllabus. Hope you are liking our videos, and if you have not subscribed the channel SRIP Edu Pharma, then do subscribe the channel. Question number 1. Posology is branch of science which deals with A. dose of drugs, B. quantity of drugs, C. both dose and quantity of drugs, and D. none of the above. So if you remember the definition of posology, then we know that it is derived from two words, posos, which means how much, and logos, which means science. And the definition is, posology is a branch of medical science which deals with dose or quantity of drugs which can be administered to a patient to get the desired pharmacological action. So if you remember in this definition, then dose or quantity, both the terms are coming. Hence the answer will be C, that is both dose and quantity of drugs. Question number 2 is, written below which is the main body of prescription? A. superscription, B. subscription, C. inscription, and D. signatura. So if you remember the parts of the prescription, then you will remember that superscription was the RX that is written on the left hand side. Then subscription is the instructions which are given for the patient or to the pharmacist. Then third is inscription, and inscription means the actual drug and the quantity that is given in the prescription, and then there is signatura, which is the signature. So here main body of the prescription is C, that is inscription. Question number 3 is, elixirs are A. alcoholic preparation, B. hydroalcoholic preparation, C. aqueous preparation, and D is non-alcoholic preparation. So if you remember the definition of elixir, then elixirs are sweetened hydroalcoholic preparations. Hence the answer is B, that is hydroalcoholic preparation. Question number 4 is, physical incompatibility occurs due to A. immiscibility, B. insolubility, C. precipitation, and D. all of the above. When you remember the definition of physical incompatibility, then we had seen that when two or more than two substances combine together, and if any physical change occurs and any type of unacceptable product is formed, then that will be physical incompatibility. So here in all these three cases, like immiscibility, insolubility, and precipitation, all these three cases physical changes are occurring. Hence the answer will be D, that is all of the above. Question number 5. Proof spirit is defined as a mixture of A. absolute alcohol and water, B. absolute alcohol and acetone, C. absolute alcohol and chloroform, and D. none of the above. Here the answer will be A, that is absolute alcohol and water, because proof spirit is combination of 57.1% ethyl alcohol and 42.9% water. So here the answer will be A. Question number 6. Theobroma oil comes under which type? A. emulsifying bases, B. water soluble bases, C. fatty bases, and D. none of the above. So if you remember, then theobroma oil is also known as coca butter, and it is widely used as semi-solid base, especially for ointments. So the answer is C, that is fatty base. Question number 7. Lozenges comes under which dosage form? A. solid dosage form, B. liquid dosage form, C. semi-solid dosage form, or D. all of the above. Here The answer will be A, that is solid dosage form, because lozenges are the solid dosage form which are specially used for dissolving or disintegrating slowly in the mouth. You might have seen various cough lozenges. It may contain anesthetic, demulcent or antiseptic, and specially it is used for medicating mouth and throat. So answer is A. Question number 8. Liniments are introduced into A. Rectum, B. Ear, C. Vagina, D. Skin. So liniments are the topical dosage form which are used by rubbing. Hence the answer is skin, because they are used in the skin. Question number 9. Particle size exists as separate entity in A. Flocculated suspension, B. Emulsion, C. Deflocculated suspension and D. Lotion. Here answer will be C, that is deflocculated suspension. Question number 10. Lotions are applied externally. A. With friction, without, B. Without friction, C. Both A and B, and D. None of the above. So, as we had studied in the definition of lotion, then lotions are liquid preparations which are meant for external application without friction. But if we remember liniments, then they are the liquid or semi-solid preparations which are applied with friction. Hence here, as lotion is asked, so answer will be B, that is without friction. Question number 11. Written below, which one not come under ointment preparation method? A. Trituration method, B. Fusion method, C. Compression method and D. Emulsification method. So in all these four methods given, you can see that odd one is compression method, because compression is done specially in the case of tablets where we do the compression. Hence the answer will be C, that is compression method, and all the other three methods are used for preparing ointments. Question 12. Among below, which don't come under solid dosage form? A. Tablet, B. Capsule, C. Gel and D. Powder. It is very easier one, except gel, all the three are solid dosage forms. As we know, gel is semi-solid form, hence the answer is C, that is gel. Question number 13. Which of the following is not used as emulsifying agent? A. Acacia, B. Tragacan, C. Methyl cellulose, D. Starch. Here answer will be starch, because except starch, all the other three are used as emulsifying agent for preparing emulsions. Question number 14. All of the following are for external use except A. Syrup, B. Lotion, C. Gargles and D. Liniment. Here odd one is syrup, because syrup is used for internal use also, and all other three are used for external use. So the answer is A, that is syrup. Question number 15. Techniques for increasing solubilization are A. Co-solvency, B. Micronization, C. Surface active agents, D. All of the above. Here all these three methods are the techniques for increasing the solubility. So the answer will be all of the above, that is D. Question number 16. Dry gum method is manufacturing method for A. Ointment, B. Emulsion, C. Suspension, D. Suppositories. Here the answer will be B, that is emulsion, because for emulsion we use wet gum method and dry gum method, especially for preparing the primary emulsion. Hence answer will be B. Question number 17. Efflorescent powder means A. Lose water to atmosphere, B. Gain water from atmosphere, C. Both A and B, and D. None of the above. Here this term is used when the powder, it has the tendency of losing water to the atmosphere. Hence answer will be A, that is lose water to atmosphere. Question number 18. Simple syrup IP contains A. 66.7% weight by weight, or B. 70%, or C62% or D55%. So simple syrup IP and simple syrup USP we know, and in the case of simple syrup IP, the quantity used is 66.7% weight by weight. Here we have to remember the unit is weight by weight, and the answer will be A. Question number 19, pharmacopoeia is A, journal, B, magazine, C, paper, D, book. In this question, various students, they get confused with journal, but the answer is not journal, the answer is D, that is book. Question number 20, creams are viscous, semi-solids, usually A, solution, B, emulsion, C, suspension, D, all of the above. So, creams, we know cold cream, vanishing cream, and they come under emulsion. Hence, the answer will be B, that is emulsion. So, in today's video, we have discussed pharmaceutics 1 multiple choice questions. If you want us to discuss any other question paper, then you can write in the comment section. So, thank you so much. Keep learning, stay connected. And do like, share and subscribe the channel SRIP Edu Pharma.